Are you using static electricity to your advantage on your farm? I'll explain in today's Iron Talk. Do you use a dry seed treatment of any kind? Inoculant, a biological product, even talc or graphite? Have you ever considered what helps those dry seed treatments and flow aids stick to your seed? It's static electricity. If you've noticed dry products ending up at the bottom of your seed boxes or blowing out with your air seeder or planter, it's due in part to the loss of static cling. If you'd like your dry products to actually stick to the seed, here's how you do it. First, let's look at the old way of doing things. If you dump dry products onto the seed and then spread them out with a broomstick or some other tool, it can work if you do it right. Rather than dumping your dry seed treatment all in one lump in the middle of the box, though, spread it out thinly around your box. By dumping it in one lump, the seed treatment actually uses up its static electricity to stick together. When you break up the clump, a good share of the seed treatment just doesn't have enough static cling left to stick to the seed, and it ends up at the bottom of your box. By spreading it out right from the beginning, the static can attract right to the seed. A better way to do all of this, though, is to eliminate the clumping and maintain all the static electricity needed to attach the dry treatment to your seed. Automate the process. We've used a CT applicator for two main reasons. First, it uses a patented sifter to break up the clumps and provide an even application of dry products to the seed. Second, unlike other treaters, CT uses a stainless steel vessel which doesn't remove the static charge like polytanks will. The result is an even distribution and less treatment that ends up at the bottom of your seed hopper or blowing out with your air system. So remember, static electricity can be your friend with dry seed treatments. That's all for today's Iron Talk, and now back to the show.